Assassin.
I think I just damaged him.
He's gonna rolling boulder and get it in the process and then get to the tier 2 tower, pull the creep wave. He might actually die here. Yep. And that's first blood for Bulba.
Oh, he did damage, so he gets the kill. Jeez.
That's not what he wanted. Yeah.
If he didn't put a stone down, he would have rolled through, got the last hit, and then been on the low ground and not rolled into the tower. But because he put the stone down, he went too far.
Meanwhile, Pasha is going to go out on a turn of strike top lane, and the rolling boulder from Yol. He's going to come in looking for Pylai Dai. He has the Orb of Venom, but Envy's here to help zone him out, and it's just going to be two quick kills going.
Yeah, I'm Morphling not a hero that rotates in the jungle that well, but
I don't know what to say about that. I kind of want to draw a casual question mark on the ground. Pylai Dai, silent step, rolling boulder. They had the boulder smash to start things. They need Posh with the void, but it's down for another 5 seconds. TP and Puppy, he's got call, I hope. No, he's only just got the battle hunger. He's level 2. Another void coming out, and Pasha needs two more right clicks. Body blocks not there for Puppy in time, and Pasha will run out with boots of speed at nighttime. Level 4 is now up, and on top, I'm going to push down this tower, but there's another hero rotating in. It is Puppy, and if they go too far, Illidan might get caught by a call, but still not there yet. He's only level 3. He actually is waiting for. No, he got 2 points of counter heal, so I think he was waiting for. Oh, but here's the Iron Shell, and Illidan might have to strength morph even further. He's got 4 stick charges, now 5, surge forward. Fate's Edict will avoid some of that Iron Shell damage. Counter heal, Prox going through. He has the creep wave on him, and Illidan might get dove. He still has those agility traits. We'll finally switch to Trank and stay alive. Counter Helix Prox missing, and Puppy might actually go down. The tower hits. He's getting blocked by the creep waves, and there's no spins, and Illidan gets the kill. RNG is not
on. It was probably like 2 spins from death. If he got a bit unlucky there, Puppy kills him, but I mean, he probably got really unlucky.
Yeah, Illidan looks like a genius now. Yol gets blocked by Arteezy. He'll find that kill. He won't find RMN. That's just a smart play.
Blow for blow, Nightstalker is a bit behind Darkseer, but he's kind of trying to be a bit more aggressive. And I think the key phase for Fantastic Five is the next night.
Well, they're going to make it night now.
Yeah, I was going to say 12 minutes in, but no, they'll accelerate that timing.
They'll just go for it. They're going to Timber Chain him, looking for Bulba and Envy. Envy does have Omni Slash, and now it looks like Fantastic Five looking to back away. Arteezy's got a side trap in one. There's the False Promise. Good Omni doesn't do nearly enough damage. Posh just takes up all of that. The sound comes through. Illidan's now in. The wall drop down doesn't get anything done. They'll lose the hero in the end. It's Fear Spirit. Now BZZ in trouble. Walks through the wall, and they get off the Blade Fury kill. They're looking for the void. Posh and Illidan walk through as well. The side trap is up. The waveform needs to go there so he can get the kill, and he will. And it will be a 2-for-2 exchange when it's all said and done. Refraction's still there. He's got plenty of charges.
Here's mana for waveform. There we go.
Puppy's looking. This could be a big call. Onto 2. He gets silenced up in the end. Still, they're just going to work with the Iron Shell. They get the call off the one dug, 2 dead. And eventually, it is Secret that takes the engagement. There's a TP coming in, but I don't think it's going to really do anything. Meanwhile, Arteezy finds another one on the backside as the Air Spirit got chased down. And so, I put you for Fantastic Five. And where's that put you for Secret? I feel like that's a really bad fight for Fantastic Five.
Oh, yeah. It's pretty awful for them. I think even before that, they were slightly behind. This kill will help things out a bit. Illidan, yep, he gets it. But the big thing was, like, the cores were on par with each other, but Secret have the reactions from him. And Fantastic Five still, they're still going to scale well. That's a Morphling Timbersaw. There are. I'm trying to like think how good are they at dealing with a Timbersaw late game. It's not bad, but I'll catch y'all out here. But as far as bursting him down, the nice thing about TA is if you
jungle camps all the time, a lot quicker with Aquila and Lincoln Sphere with
Perseverance. Because you're a hero that doesn't naturally jungle, you have to take damage to jungle.
There's that Meld Strike you were talking about with no reactive armor stacks. If he's just dead to the Static Storm, Yol's going to have to just hightail it out of there. 40 seconds. Glimpse comes through. Posh is going to get put back. Arteezy, though, might be in trouble. Magnetize. That's a pretty good trade, as Illidan is the one that gets that. That is, bro. And maybe when he gets this Bloodstone, it'll be different. Envy is going to be close to Pasha. He's going to find him. Can they get the silence off? Yes, the Void will come out. They need a Fortune's End. There's nobody else over here. They're going to get that Fortune's End off. They're going to bring him down with the Purifying Flames. Dead for 45, 314 for Illidan. He's the prime target. Yol as well. This could be a big blink call, but it's not there. He misses. Waveform in time. Adaptive Strike, but there's going to be the... Oh, man, they missed the Static Storm on everyone. The Magnetize coming through. And Yol gets his False Promise at the tail end of the engagement. Chakra Arteezy melted up, will maybe go down, but he just barely gets the refraction off. Great call to stop any further damage. The Magnetize will bring him down. Misses the call. BZZ stays alive. They get the kill with more Purifying Flames. It's a 3-for-1 exchange. And Fantastic Five, what an engagement.
Yeah.
Wow.
It was so hard for Puppy to find the heroes for the blink call. He kind of had to blindly guess with that blink in and can't really threaten this.
And he's going to get rolling bouldered on. Vision across the
I love it.
The ravine from Yol.
delay
the boulder smash, and there it is. I mean, it gives him enough time to get the HS unhealed, and they can get out. They know that he's there, too. He's going to walk up and try to CS. Instead, they're going to go to the back lines, look for Puppy.
They can't get it easily if you get the blink off, because it's a waste of time.
And Z is going to go ahead and try to CC out. Call will be under three. The Static Storm on top of it. This might be a good fight. Back wall onto all five. Can they get the kills done here? They've already gotten the Oracle. Magnetized up on Bulba. They might lose him. Still, though, a pretty good fight, all things considered, for Secret. It's a 1-for-2 exchange so far. Illidan might lose the Sages, but he will almost get Puppy in the process. The Omni Slash comes through. It's on the go, Scepter and Illidan. Still a 1-for-nothing, or rather, 1-for-3 exchange, and now BZC's too far, and he went for that Timbersaw Chakram Willing Death. Now he's able to get up to the Timbersaw or Timber Chain up to the high ground. Glimpse back is there, and he will end up going down. He'll try the Timber Chain again, and finally, Secret with a huge Static coming out, and Secret will exit to the right. I don't know if they've been... Oh, yes, they have the Replicate up. And Illidan just jumps in. He gets the Ethereal Blade off. Pylai Dai gets dropped down by the Adaptive Strike.
They mech'd in Healing Water for that. See some of Secret's Roche-taking potential. Secret, who drafted very much around this being a slower-paced Roche game. You have to be scared of going for Roche when Nightstalker is at.
Oh, Pasha is going to get glimpsed back, and that Axe is gone. They'll bring him down first. That's just the damage with Desolator. Not even using the BKB, not in each tower.
Yeah, it was a fairly fast, like a 45-second Roche respawn, which... benefit Secret. If Nightstalker respawns before Roche is up, Fantastic Five can contest it, so another lane and force you back.
Which is what he's been doing for a couple of minutes now. He did that in the top lane, just as you saw. They'll have to clear out that creep wave, and really, oh, alright, well, I thought I heard a Static Storm. For Yol, okay.
There's like so many items he needs. The Shivers is by no means a bad choice. It's just a different approach to the game.
Ooh, are they going to find Envy? Boulder Smash comes through. Waveform Adaptive Strike pops the BKB. Can he TP out in time? Timberchain is up. BKB, Shiva's Guard coming through. They need more right click. Do they have the job? They do. And he is down for 83. He does have buyback. That is probably the most important kill so far in this game for Fantastic Five. But it looks like they will have to trade Roche for it. And that's almost not worth it.
Just kind of goes back to the Blink Dagger pickup on Earth Screen. It's just a great item selection because it gives him that Blink, like, melee stun opportunity onto the Envy Jug. And that was where the damage... It allowed them to get the shotgun damage without him Blade Fury dodging. And then he can't Blade Fury TP because he'll die to the physical.
They'll find Pylai die at the very least with the Boulder Smash. The Void comes through. They had to wait for the Kinetic Field to go down. Fortune's in. Everyone's already TP'd back, so Pylai die is left to his own devices. He did buy before dying, so at least that's going well for him.
Confident to try and
breach the high
ground.
He's got his Manta back up. He could just go in Manta and maybe even have himself. He's got a BKB. I don't see... Oh, God.
No glyph on the Radiant side,
this
though.
Is bad. I think they just lose their melee racks, I'm pretty sure. Although the Shiva's Guard will go. They get the Boulder Smash off. Arteezy does have the Aegis. Magnetize will go. The Void's up next. Strax's still there. He's got it. Still not using it. Meanwhile, now the TPs will go. Ranged Strax taken down by Illidan. And here comes Puppy. Misses the call, though. Adaptive Strike. He's got the Ethereal Blade, but he gets the Force out. Eats the cheese. Waveform comes through. Illidan still wants this kill. Meanwhile, everyone is getting chased down. They did take down
they're
the Aegis, mind you. And Arteezy gets Boulder Smash to silence up. The Force Dev has to pop the BKB. They are missing that right click, though, from Illidan. He actually got the melee racks, but now it looks like everyone is dying for Fantastic Five. It's Secret. They just get Arteezy to pop his BKB. BZZ will go down momentarily. He's caught by the kinetic field. Timberchain out, but now Arteezy's here with some surge, and that's a triple kill for him.
Very close to bring down Envy there. I think... as soon as you mentioned Sky, I'm like, that actually sounds better.
Oh,
than
the courier's been scouted. And V sees it. Oh, okay, he bought everything.
Oh, I was about to say, if
he
hadn't bought
everything. As bad as it was for Envy to lose that set of racks, it's going to be even worse if Illidan goes down in this fight. Although he is very strong, even without Scotty. Puppy jumps in, gets the call onto PZZ. He bought back, and he's the one that dies without buyback. And now, this is looking bad. BKBs were popped, though, not for Arteezy necessarily. Lincoln Spear was broken, and I think they were looking for a glimpse or something to just try to break it. Waveform through, they get the... Nildan's gonna pop the BKB in man fight. I don't know if this is gonna work. Bulba's gonna get caught, magnetized, Static Storm on top, misses on everyone. They will bring down Yol nonetheless, and Illidan, this man fight is not working. The False Promise, Envy does some serious damage, and he even goes down after the False Promise.
Oh,
Fantastic
no.
Five might have just ended the game for themselves. Secret putting themselves in a great position now, and it looks like they will move on to the TI main event, and well done from this squad. They made a couple of mistakes here at the end of the game, but when it came to crunch time, they were able to get the job done, it looks like.
That was just such a brutal way to lose the game. Losing your Scotty, and then how far away from buyback is he? He got us like 1,700 gold.
He was 300 at one point. It's 200 now.
Oh, that is just...
Once they killed that courier, they knew that he probably had bought something there.
I mean, this game was still a very even game. Even with the Rax advantage, it still felt like momentum was, like, Secret were more the ones in control, but to lose in that fashion as Fantastic Five is just great.
He's like, okay, we killed the courier. There's probably a morphling item on the courier at this point in time. And with that, we probably try to force in. They find themselves to kill on BZZ. And Illidan kind of has to do it all on his own. They get off the stone form with the Enchant Remnant pushing back. He gets forced forward, pops the BKB. He might still die to the well and will, but they'll barely defend, and I can't even really call it defending at this point. They've lost Megas, and Pilot Eye might go down, but that's really only a small consolation prize. He might even get out, honestly. No, he's dead. Okay.
I mean, I guess we can't quite call this game just yet with a morph. Like, six, so I was like, well, okay, so it didn't have... For a second, I didn't think it had the Scotty, and he stole the money, so...
Courier? No, Pasha, you won't be able to... You won't be as lucky as Envy. And that's too dead.
Yeah.
And probably the entire team now. As Illidan's gonna have to pop the BKB, the Omni Smash will go. Good Ghost Scepter's coming out, but probably too much at this point. Waveform away, BCB too far, and they get the call. Good false promise, but he's not doing nearly enough damage, and that is it. They Culling Blade and Static Storm for Victory Parade, and Team Secret will move on to the TI main event. And really, was there any doubt this team was star-studded and made it through the open qualifiers with relative ease?
There were some doubts.
Yeah, all right.
Open qualifiers, thrown on 1,000 HP. I think Secret fans had a lot of doubts, but...
Pro Dota, best team, EU perhaps, or what the other team they were really down against as well. But
they had some close shaves in the open qualifiers. Need to say they were still the second one, but regionals... They delivered. They had some close games, but they definitely looked like the best team in regionals. So I think they are well deserving of that spot at TI.
So all together, gods, it...